Hi everyone, welcome back with another session of geography. So today we will continue the same chapter, that is motions of earth. Now in the previous section we have already discussed about the rotation, revolution and the effects of rotation and effects of revolution. So the revolution of earth has the one big effect, that is the occurrence of various seasons. Alright. So today we'll discuss all about it. So when we talk about the seasons, so seasons are caused by the revolution of earth around the sun and also the tilt of earth's axis. All right, so here you can see the diagram. So here you can see that it starts from the 21st of March and it continues. All right, so Earth is in different position. So the first one that we have, that is on 21st of March, this position is called the spring equinox or vernal equinox. Okay, so let's discuss this one by one. So when we talk about the spring equinox, alright, so the first thing that comes up in mind, so what is the meaning of this equinox? Now the word equinox comes from the Latin and it means equality of night and day. Understood? It means equality of night and day. Now the equinox occurs at two specific moments in time when the sun is exactly above the equator. Alright, so this equinox occurs at two specific moments in time. Fine. Now first one we have here, that is the spring equinox. We also know it as the vernal equinox or the March equinox, as it takes place in the month of March. Now on 21st of March, the rays of the sun fall directly on the equator. Alright, so what happens? The northern hemisphere experiences spring season, while the southern hemisphere, they experiences autumn season during this time. Alright, now during this time the North Pole and the South Pole are equidistant from the Sun. So the distance of North Pole and South Poles are equal from the Sun. So that's why what happens, the duration of days and nights all over the world is equal on that particular day. Alright. So as it is given here, 21st of March, so sometimes it differs also, it becomes 20th or 22nd of March also. So every year it sometimes it changes. So approximately a date has been chosen, that is 21st of March. Alright, now next we have, that is the autumnal equinox. Okay, so like the spring equinox, on 23rd of September, once again, the rays of the sun fall directly on the equator. Alright, now this time, the southern hemisphere experiences the spring season, while the northern hemisphere, they experiences the autumn season during this time. Now the same thing happens, that is the North Pole and the South Poles becomes equal, they are having equidistant from the sun. Alright, and that's why the duration of nights and days are equal all over the world. Alright, so these are the two specific moments when the sun is exactly above the equator. One is, that is 21st of March, another is, that is 23rd of September. So like I said, sometimes it differs, sometimes 21st of March becomes 20th of March or 22nd of March. The same way this autumnal equinox also differs, sometimes 22nd or 23rd of September. Okay, so these are all about the equinox. So now the same like the spring and autumn, so the earth also comes in a position which is also on 21st of June, and that position is called the summer solstice. Alright, the summer solstice. Now, so let's talk about this summer solstice. Okay, so when we talk about this summer solstice, the summer solstice is also known as estival solstice or midsummers. All right, so it occurs when one of the earth poles has its maximum tilt towards the sun. Understood. So on 21st of June, the North Pole is inclined towards the sun. The North Pole is inclined towards the sun. So what happens is the sun rays fall directly on the Tropic of Cancer, which is present in the Northern Hemisphere. All right. So as the North Pole is inclined, so the sun rays is falling directly on the Tropic of Cancer. So because of this, it is the summer time in the Northern Hemisphere, and therefore it experiences longer days and shorter nights. It experiences longer days and shorter nights. And also, the longest day and the shortest night of the year is on 21st of June. Alright, now the sun travels the longest path through the sky during this time, and that day therefore has the most daylight. Okay, the same way like the summer solstice, the same way we have the winter solstice. So what happens in the winter solstice? Let's see. Now winter solstice, it's like on 22nd of December, the South Pole is inclined towards the sun. So as it happens on 21st of June, the North Pole is inclined. The same way on 22nd of December, the South Pole is inclined towards the sun. Now as I have said the dates, now the summer solstice, its dates is around 21st of June. Sometimes it falls on 20th of June or 22nd of June. The same way the winter solstice, it sometimes falls on 22nd of December or sometimes 23rd of December. Alright, so the condition of summer solstice are reversed in winter solstice. Fine. Now on 22nd of December, the South Pole is inclined towards the sun. Understood. And like the summer solstice, during this time, the sun rays fall directly on the Tropic of Capricorn, which is present on the Southern Hemisphere. Understood. Now, because of this, it is summer in the Southern Hemisphere, and therefore it experiences longer days and shorter nights. So as on 21st of June it becomes the longer days and shorter nights in the Northern Hemisphere, the same thing happens on 22nd of December in the Southern Hemisphere. And same way it becomes the longest day and the shortest night of the year on 22nd of December. All right, so these are all about the equinox and the solstice. Fine. So that's it for today. I hope you liked the video, understood the topics that we have discussed. Till the next time, bye bye.